Amen.
Sorry, I'm talking about Lydia a lot. Okay, that was, again, another Kairos moment for me, and I got to come to church on Wednesdays, which was a bonus for me going to, on Sundays with my parents. But then we moved back to the house, and I couldn't go to prayer, and Annie Vo was not able to pick me up to come to church. And then I started going down after Christmas break. I really wasn't doing bad, but I was not doing great. I was born a Christian. I stopped praying, I stopped reading my Bible. And, when that started happening, I started losing friends and at school, and I was being slapped in the face at school, and so that wasn't very good. But at that time, it was really hard for me, because I was really lonely, but then I remembered I'm never alone, and soon I got some more friends, and they were better than the ones I had. But right before youth camp, I thought, I need to start reading my Bible more, praying. Then I started thinking to myself, well, I'll do it after youth. It's after youth camp, and I'm not going back, and I can tell you, it has been a journey, but I'm so glad he didn't throw my play away. The word which came, well, now I'm going to read Jeremiah 18. The word which came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, arise and go down to the potter's house, and there I will cause thee to hear my words. Then I went down to the potter's house, and behold, he wrought a work on the wheel. And the vessel that he made of clay was marred in the hand of the potter. So he made it again, another vessel, as it seemed good to the potter to make it. Then the word of the Lord came to me, saying, O house of Israel, can I not do with you as the potter? It is his hands that formed us, each of us, so greatly and gently. In the text, it says the clay was marred, which means in Greek, it is spoiled, corrupted, and ruined. So yet he works on us so gently and with such care. He knows us by name, not by number, like the government. Yet we go out and we betray him, but he doesn't give up on us because he loves us. His definition of love is love suffers not and is kind, love envious not, love wrong man. it's not all about itself.
Right.
It is not puffed up, does not behave itself unseemingly, seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil, rejoice not in iniquity.
Mm-hmm.
And rejoices the truth. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopes all things, endureth all things. So, then we go out and do worldly things while he watches us from above, still on his wheel. And if we don't ask for forgiveness and repent, he still is forming our clay. And he has the power over the clay. He is trying to make us, you, a useful vessel, and you must soon repent or time will pass and the clay will harden, but it's still marred. Then it will be worth nothing and it will be broken and destroyed. He has sacrificed so much. Wait, no. But then, God, because God loves us so much, and he's an all-forgiving God, he picks up our broken shards, for he's forgiving, and he goes back to the wheel, and he goes to work again. He has sacrificed so much, and we really take it for granted. All the pain that we feel, the sorrow, the hurt, everything. Everything you go through in life. He had to carry all of that, plus the rest of the world. It says in the Bible, he bottles up every single tear we have shed. But you know what hasn't? Who hasn't? What? No. You know who? What hasn't done all of this for you? Drugs.
Mm-hmm.
Sin. Fleshly desires. Satan. They didn't do all of that for you. So why do them?
That's right.
He made this world and he knows your name again. And what do you go? And what? What you are going through, he listens when you hurt and weak, and you're weak, and helps you walk through the through. There is no mountain that we can't face without him. He is always here with us. The Bible says that it only takes a faith amount of mustard seed to move a mountain. Even though sometimes you feel like no one's here, he does. No one hears you. He does, and it is all part of his plan. So if you think you have gone too far into the world and you can't come back, He's waiting for you, arms wide open. Just like with the prodigal son, he had hurt his father so much, but when he came running home, the father hugged him with joy and relief and threw a party. He is still waiting for you. All you have to do is ask him to recreate your marred clay, repent, and run to him with arms wide open. And then I just kind of like the scripture, and so I wanted to say it. So Christ has truly set us free. Now make sure that we stay free and don't get tied up again in slavery.